Okay, here we go. Good evening, everyone. This is Katz from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. Yokoso News is the online website to introduce Japan in English so that you can understand Japan more. Hello, everyone. This is Katz from Yokoso News. Again, we are back for the emergency broadcast, the weekly emergency broadcast, what's going on about nuclear power plant and earthquake tsunami incident. But before that, let me promote Yokoso News and then moving on to the stuff. Everyone, don't miss Dr. Shinsaku, the recorded archive that's available on Yokoso News. And then I did the Japanese calligraphy demonstration yesterday as well. So that's already available at yokosonews.com or Yokoso News on the YouTube. And I'm gonna do this show on Sunday. It's called Japanese Curry Brainwashing. JCB. This Sunday coming up. So please also check it out. Our regular programming at the Yokoso News. Since the March 11th earthquake and nuclear power plant incident, I've decided to, part of the Yokoso News purpose is to also inform people in English as much as possible from Japan in the case of the disaster. That's how I designed Yokoso News from the beginning, since I organized this Yokoso News. I dedicate this broadcast to two kinds of people. First kinds of people is the people who live in Japan, like Borden.
And good evening, everybody.
Good evening. And then, so that, many people don't understand Japanese. Borden do understand some Japanese, but many people don't really understand Japanese, the people who live in Japan. I'm here to help people to get you informed what's going on in Japan. And then second kind of people I like this broadcast dedicated to is the people who don't live in Japan but who have direct relationship to Japan. It's because you have a loved one, friend, family member live in Japan. And as now, Yokoso News was one of the first English media to report the earthquake and tsunami, but Yokoso News is also the last one to keep getting you informed what's really happening in Japan, so that I try to bring you as much info as possible. So since I cannot really keep doing this everyday broadcast, I used to be doing this every day, but now I turning back to weekly broadcast. So I'm doing this weekly broadcast every 8 p.m. on Tuesday. I'm thinking about doing this for 3 months. So I'm thinking about doing at least weekly until June. We'll see about that afterwards. During this show, it's kind of looks boring, but mainly audio driven. We talk about what has been happening in Japan. So today, I have Jim Borden on Skype. What's up, Jim?
Hi, Katz. Hi, everybody. From Kazo, Saitama, Japan.
Where is Kazo Saitama?
Well, it's right on the border between Saitama Prefecture and Ibaraki Prefecture.
Okay.
I can literally ride my bicycle to Ibaraki.
Okay. Cool. Cool. So it's north of Tokyo, right?
Yes, very north of Tokyo. The northernmost part of Tokyo, Kitaku, is about 55 minutes from my train station.
Okay. Okay.
It's halfway between Tokyo and Utsunomiya, which is a big city in Tochigi Prefecture.
Yep, yep. So, Jim lived the north side of Japan. Okay, I see, start seeing on the Ustream, social stream. Hey, everyone. CQ Dude, what's up? Yoshia Reichman, what's up? I got haircut 2 weeks ago. Liz, good morning. Ustream is cutting me up visually and sound. How am I, Jim? Am I cutting visually?
Visually a little bit. Like every 3 or 4 seconds, it gets kind of artifacts going on.
Artifact, but not like not
like
really.
It's sudden, like it's switching between high quality and low quality. You know that low quality on YouTube where everything looks kind of boxy.
Yeah. But it doesn't really stop digitally or stuff, right?
You know, it's not stuttering or buffering or anything, but you know, so, I'm in the same country.
yeah. Okay, cool. Okay, cool. So I think it should be okay, huh? Okay, but all right, and Octotiny, thank you, Octotiny. She is the winner of a Japanese calligraphy contest yesterday, and I just went to post office and I just tweetcast the show. I just went to post office and went to buy soft cream and then takoyaki. Taiyaki, and then you know so. Yeah. Okay. Hey, Damian, what's up? So let's go. Let's talk about Jim. So
let's talk about me.
Let's talk about Jim. So as you might guys know, last weekend, like from the first, like towards the end of the April to the beginning of May, we have the week so-called Golden Week. Golden Week is the like we have many national holiday from April 29th to May 3rd to May 5th. One is Children's Day, Greenery Day, and then Constitution Day, and what's the April 29th?
Showa Day.
Showa Day, yes, Showa Day.
The birthday of the previous emperor.
Emperor, yes. How come I forgot and you knew it?
Well, I just looked it up recently.
Oh,
and
okay.
I had to remember the kanji for writing on my monthly report, so.
Okay, got it. So because of that, many people actually went to the North Japan to volunteer during the Golden Week. Many people did cancel during the Golden Week because it's such a long holiday. It's like a Thanksgiving holiday, you know, in the US, in between the summer vacation and then Christmas vacation. You kind of have a, you know, Thanksgiving weekend holiday, that kind of stuff. So that was the last week, and many people decided to go volunteer in the north, and that's including Jim, who is on the Ustream, on Skype right now. So I just gonna turn into you, Jim, and then, so would you, Would you tell me about your experience, Jim?
Well, you know, the experience personally for me, well, it had its good moments and its bad moments. Well, that's to be expected. I didn't get to sleep very much for about a 38 to 40 hour period, so it's hard to stay, you know, positive through the entire thing. But overall, I'm very happy that I was able to go because you know it doesn't matter about me really.
Okay.
It matters about them. They need help, and I can give it. I went to. Well, as you can see, Katz is putting up the movie that I took now. I went to a city called Ishinomaki.
Yeah.
It's next to Onagawa. Many people know Onagawa City because of the nuclear power plant. I couldn't see the nuclear power plant from where I was, but it's 30 miles or so northeast of Sendai, and it's 80 miles northeast of Fukushima Daiichi power plant. So there's not really any radiation danger there, just a lot of destruction. It really, really looked like a bomb went off there. Like, I was in denial the whole time, like, oh, where am I? I feel like I'm on another planet.
Why did you end up? Well, first of all, why did you end up going to volunteering in Ishinomaki in the first place?
Well, that's a bit of a strange story. But I'd ever since the earthquake actually happened, you know, I donated money and stuff, but I didn't feel like I wanted to do something more direct because, you know, I'm already here in Japan and I can speak Japanese and, you know, I'm still young, so I can carry stuff easily, more easily than, you know, some of the older people can. So I want to put those, you know, manual labor skills to use. And so I asked all my friends, you know, say, if you see any opportunities for volunteering, you know, please tell me, because, you know, I'm totally ready to go. Like, I want to go there, and I know that I can't go there right away because, you know, in the beginning, you know, I'll just be in the way. You need to be a professional, but now it's not critical. The people, I'm getting sidetracked. The reason I ended up going was because my friend's friend. My friend's 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 coworker is the one that organized this, and my friend's 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 coworker told my friend's friend's friend.
Okay.
And my friend's friend's friend told my friend's friend, who told my friend, who told me. And so she said, you know, it's going to be pretty rough. Like, they're going to sleep in the car, and there was all these changes to the schedule all the time. But... you know, I said, you know what? I'll just suck it up and go. I'm just gonna tell them I'm going. And then I got a cold 3 days before I was supposed to leave, and so I was like, oh no. I got better just in time to go. But I met this guy for the first time outside of a train station, got in his car, and drove 8 hours up to Miyagi.
Okay. So it was kind of random, but you just hop into the car with who are they?
They're just a bunch of people that know each other through other people, like friends of friends and former coworkers. And I should tell you more about them. The two the my friend's friend's friend coworker and my friend's friend's friend. They go like every weekend. They go up there every weekend, and they're bringing supplies, and they ask, like, what do you need? And then they come back and they get it, and, you know, they bring it up there, and you know, I don't know how they're not running out of money. I asked the guy, like, you know, how do you afford all this? And he said, well, you know, I pretty much have no money. But I don't know, they seem to have like sources for wholesale. Like, we had boxes full of eggs and, you know, and tons of donated clothing.
Mm. I see.
I guess I should say what I actually did.
Yeah, no, it's okay, it's okay. No, it's so it's like that's the beauty of the volunteering, because sometimes it may not organize, but as long as you have a passion, as long as you have a little bit of the resource, you can carry on sometime. You know, it could be impulsive, but yet, you know, because the scale is so huge, you kind of need some kind of the organization to a certain extent, but you could go a little bit impulsive sometime too. But so you hop into the car. When was it?
That was on around 8 p.m. on May 3rd.
Okay.
So then, the first of the three holidays in the middle of the week there.
Yeah. Then, so please tell me what happened.
Well, I got in this tiny little car, and there was five people in it. Well, okay. I knew we were going to stop at the next service area and split into the three cars. So there was a total of 10 people. There was the guy who drove us, Mr. Akari, and three girls, Satomi-san, Mayu-san, and Yoko-san. And then the actual organizer, his name is Ryo-san.
Uh-huh.
And he came with his... No, it's somebody else. This woman named Yuko-san, uh-huh, and her niece, who's actually an elementary school student.
Oh.
She's about 10 years old, and her name is Noeru-chan.
Really?
And her father, Mr. Isamu.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's everybody. And you can see in the picture up there, right? Well, I don't actually know how. Yeah, you can at the picture right now, you see that's how we were set up there. We were offering... We were cooking food. We were cooking Korean food.
Korean
chijimi,
food?
Yeah, uh-huh. Chijimi, Korean soup, and we made cotton candy too. You can see the cotton candy machine, that's the orange thing with the picture of the cotton candy on it. The cotton candy was a very big hit.
So what's the main purpose, like what's the main project of you guys' group?
Well, their group, they just want to make sure that they have everything they need or that they want.
In Ishinomaki.
Yeah, in Ishinomaki. And I don't know how many they actually go to. I think they might go to more than just this one. This one was a pretty small shelter. It's an old JA. JA is Japan agriculture.
Yeah.
The farming, the big farming industry in Japan.
Yeah.
They have offices in various places in Japan. And this one survived the tsunami. You can see some of the houses here have survived the tsunami,
yeah,
but you know they still have running water or gas.
Mm.
They have some electricity, but you know not enough for like they ration it for to use with refrigerators and stuff.
Yeah,
and they're all in the, there's about 40 people in this office, farm office building.
Yeah,
they're living there and. See, there's the chijimi. It's similar to okonomiyaki.
Yeah, it's Korean.
Korean savory pancakes.
Yeah. Then, so,
we cooked all day. We started at, we got delayed by, I don't know, we stopped a lot and took breaks, and we finally got to Ishinomaki. We stayed in a parking lot, and we got there at about 4 in the morning, and everyone took a nap until 7.
Uh-huh.
Except me, because you know I'm almost 6 feet tall and I'm in the back of a matchbox car. So, and Mr. Akari fell asleep with the heater on, and I swear it was 40 degrees in 40 degrees Celsius. I woke up and I'm like, I'm in hell, where am I?
But then?
After he woke up, I got out of the car. I'm just like, forget it. I'm waiting outside. And so after that, we drove over. And up until that point, I hadn't seen any destruction or anything out of the ordinary.
Mm.
But we started driving. And then I was wondering, like, you know, are the pictures on TV like, you know, did they just take them like where it was the worst and it's not like that? But then all of a sudden we crossed this bridge and it was just like bam, everything just like a line between destruction and normalness.
Yeah.
We drove into, we had to drive pretty slowly because most of the roads are just like a bunch of dirt.
Yeah.
It reminds me of America. And
What reminds
the crappy roads?
Oh. Where are you from, Borden?
Upstate New York. You know, I literally have a dirt road next to my house.
Okay. Well, I mean, you haven't lived in the countryside of Japan yet, though. I have a dirt road nearby my house, but. Yeah, so you see the destruction there and stuff.
Yeah.
So in the morning you serve. So pretty much you just stay at the JA building all day long.
Well, I'll tell you what happened later. There was a really fun thing that they let me do, and I'll get to that in a minute.
Okay.
But we got there around just before 8 a.m.
Uh huh.
And we spent 3 hours, you know, doing preparation, setting up the propane stuff. And I spent 45 minutes cutting up nira.
Oh, 45 nira.
45 minutes cutting nira, and the smell was so strong. And for people that don't know nira, I never saw nira before my volunteering trip. I mean, I might have, but I didn't know what it was.
It's a green onion, kind of.
Yeah, in English it's called garlic chive.
Oh yeah, garlic. Yeah.
Or Chinese leek.
Yeah.
And we cut up so many of them, and you could smell it from like 50 feet away.
But that's the essential for the chijimi.
Yeah, it's
Korean pancake.
Many kinds of Asian cooking.
Yeah.
It's very popular vegetable in Asia, and it's recently becoming a little bit popular in English-speaking countries, I read, but only recently.
Mm.
But, so yeah, we cut up those, and we set up everything, and, you know, then we just sort of started making it, you know, trial and error to get the taste about right.
Uh-huh.
And we ended up eating quite a bit of it ourselves, too. Actually, not as many people showed up as we thought we're going to. We prepared for about 300 or 400, and I think at most 60 came.
Oh, okay.
And most of them were children and elderly people.
Mm.
I think the theory goes, and this is what I was told, that all the able-bodied adults are outside during the day. You know, they go crazy sitting inside, and they want to go. They go out and help. Clean up stuff. Clean up the rubble. There's a lot of volunteer groups there. There was one you can see right behind me in that area, a little bit after this picture was taken, there was a volunteer group there cleaning up stuff.
Yeah.
And there was other people handing out food too. So we had kind of a competition. That might have been why not as many people showed up.
Okay.
But if we could even give it to like one person, then, you know, it's good. Oh, look, you can see the volunteer person right there in the red shirt way in the back.
Yeah.
They were carrying out lots of old tatami mats in the back of that truck.
Mm.
And after we were serving for a while, we got started at 10 because...
Uh-huh. You were preparing.
Yeah, at 10:30, they asked me to get in the truck. And I think they thought it would be very amusing if... The only foreigner around for like dozens of miles would be the one shouting on the megaphone in Japanese that we were giving out food. So I went around all around. We drove all around, and I said the same line 50 times.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's why you are driving this driving shot.
Oh, no. This was going to...
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, never mind then. So you were saying... What you have to say?
I had to say... 本日, ただいまより, JA 石巻 綿の橋店にて 炊き出しと綿飴を無料配布いたします。
Okay, from today at the JA, the branch.
JA Ishinomaki Watano.
The branch. And then you guys gonna give out the food and the watame. What's watame in English?
Cotton candy.
Cotton candy, yeah. So
it's actually the same as the kanji for cotton and the kanji for candy.
Mm.
Yeah. But actually, I heard they call it watagashi in places other than Eastern Japan.
Mm.
So yeah, I said that line into a megaphone, the hand mic.
Yeah, yeah.
until my voice started to go away. the guy was just like, say it again, say it louder. Wait, don't say it now because these are the army people and they're gonna get annoyed. Okay, go now. Wait, we already said it here. Stop.
Okay.
Then we got back, you know, cooked some more, and then around 2 p.m. I realized that I'd been standing in the sun all day, and this had not happened in 2011 yet, and I thought, oh no, I'm going to get a sunburn, and yeah. I did. I got a really bad sunburn.
Oops.
So yeah, we cooked, and we had a lot of clothes that were donated, children's clothes.
Uh-huh.
Mountain of children's clothes.
Yeah, that's right here.
And only like 10% of them got taken. Mm. Yes, all those clothes, and we had shoes, and we had toys. An elementary student baseball team came, and there was a baseball and a toy plastic baseball and, you know, a game to play where you had to throw it at the different squares and try to hit them. So they had fun playing with that for a while. And we gave them all lots of cotton candy until they started running away when we offered it to them.
Okay.
Mr. Real was crazy about the cotton candy. He made this gigantic cotton candy and just started running at this elementary school girl and was like, "Here, have a cotton candy." And she's just like, "Oh my God, it's huge." After they left, they rode back on they rode past on their bicycles again, and he ran out and was just like, "How about some cotton candy?" And they're like, "Yada!" And they ran away.
Well, that's good that you guys are giving some joy to the people in the disaster area too. I mean,
yeah.
Sometime you need so yeah. I also heard that many of the what do you see like then okay then no maybe I'll do the question section afterwards. Like Liz, I know we have a question about debris, and then yeah, so yeah, so what happened afterwards?
Well, we had to start tearing, shutting stuff down at around 4 because once it gets dark there's no lights, and so it's hard to see.
Mm.
So we broke everything down, and we cleaned up the best we could. We cleaned up the area that we used because we made a huge mess on the ground.
Oh my God!
And there's a bunch of like middle-aged ladies that live in the shelter right now, and they're all incredibly cheerful. I was really surprised. Most of the people were kind of, they seemed tired, and they wanted to be thankful, but they were just really jaded. And we had a lot of leftovers. We had about 90 eggs and 2 buckets of nida. So we walked up to them with the buckets of nida and said, "Here, do you want all this chopped up garlic chive?" And they were like, well, okay, we'll take it. And they made a soup for us. They made a soup for us out of the eggs and the garlic chives.
Mm.
They invited us in afterwards, and they were like, "Oh, here, take this. Oh, we're so happy."
Mm.
And they offered us like onigiri and some snacks that they'd made. And I'm sitting there like, why am I taking food from an emergency shelter? Like, come on. I don't want to take it.
Yeah.
They told us that they get onigiri every day, and they bring them onigiri every day, and they have so many, and they don't know what to do with them.
Ah, I see, I see.
But actually, at that point, I wasn't hungry. I was tired, and my stomach hurt. So after that, after we got done, and they gave us coffee and stuff, so they can heat stuff up there.
But no electricity. How about the water? Tap water.
They don't have any running water, but the water truck came twice while we were there.
Ah, okay.
Water truck came twice. The post office came once. Sagawa Transport came twice. We gave some food to the Sagawa Transport guy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so there's a lot of... Then, of course, the self-defense force military personnel were around doing stuff. So there's a lot of activity going on there.
Okay.
A lot of people helping out.
I see. So what did you do after you clean up the place? So how long did you stay?
That was just the one day.
Okay. So what happened? What happened afterwards?
Drove back to Saitama.
Oh, so every day you go back to Saitama?
No. We went there. We were there all day on the 4th, and we left on the night of the 4th and got back on the morning of the 5th because some of the people had to work on the 6th.
Okay. So you just went one day?
Yeah, it was one day. Well, I mean, it was more than one day for me with all the driving, but it was one day that we actually did the food.
Okay. So,
There's one more thing I should say. That there's no, not that I know of, there was no toilets there.
So what did you do?
Well, I asked, like, you know, what should I do if I have to go to the bathroom? And Mr. Akari brought me around the corner to this hole near someone's house. It's just like, here, use this.
Okay.
I'm like, are you sure? Because, you know, this is kind of like awkward. This isn't right next to someone's house. He's like, yeah, it's fine. Just make sure you put it in the hole. But the girls, well, they just didn't go to the bathroom all day. I was shocked. We were there for 12 hours.
Okay.
I asked them that after, and they're like, yeah, it was 12 hours. And I was like, what?
Well, if they just stay like, one day, maybe they could do it, but it's not really healthy. But,
yeah.
You know, that's actually one of the concern too. One day I can break down what happened in case of the disaster one day, because, these stuff is going to be the concern of, after the earthquake or disaster. Like, you're going to lose all the infrastructure that you think you realize how you live in a developing country, how you are you receive the benefit of those technology and stuff. But so what was your what was your impression about so far?
It's really hard to believe. Obviously, it's the first time that I've ever seen that much chaos and destruction. I mean, when I was in junior high school, we had a severe tornado that went through the city near me. And even that was nothing compared to what I saw in Ishinomaki and the surrounding areas. So, you know, it's hard to think about it, like, just kind of deny it, like, you know, it's over there and I'm over here and it's like another planet. But there's a few of the people, the middle-aged ladies, who were remaining in high spirits, and even though I looked around and I saw like the apocalypse everywhere, I also couldn't look anywhere without seeing people, you know, pitching in and helping out. And the few businesses that are able to open are, you know, doing their services for free.
Oh.
There's a ramen shop that was giving out free ramen.
Oh. I see.
I'd like to go back and do it again. This time I might bring someone that I actually know.
Okay.
But that was the biggest problem for my mental state. I was not only the only foreigner, but I was the only one who didn't know anyone before I went.
Okay. Well, I mean, there are some organization organized for the foreigner and stuff too. So hopefully, I can come back if you can speak Japanese, there are many volunteer group that organize it too.
Yeah, my Japanese skill went incredibly down after about 27 hours of no sleep.
yeah. What did you have to prepare for going to volunteer?
You know, he said don't bring a lot because we don't have a lot of space. I brought with me, he said bring food for at least the journey up there. The drive up there and the drive back. And so I stocked up on onigiri and some other things. And then I realized that nobody else brought food and I was the only one, so.
Okay.
Well, why not?
So pretty much you could just bring yourself.
I brought myself some food and I brought a neck pillow. A tiny pillow.
Okay.
And of course I had to bring some money. It's incredibly, incredibly expensive. It's really expensive to go up there. Like the highway tolls. Oh man, from the highway tolls I was in awe. It was 8,050 yen to go up to there, and that's about $80.
Yeah.
The same distance in America, I couldn't imagine it costing more than 10.
Or free. Or I guess it's just gas.
Yeah, and yeah. we had three cars.
Yeah, and that's why Japanese government is thinking about making the expressway free temporarily. But that's in one of the update today. But yes, Liz posted the website called taskeijapan.jp. That's the website that I recommend to go if you wanted to get volunteer in North Japan, because Taskei Japan, you know, Taskei Japan is the website. All the information are like taskeijapan.jp. So taskeijapan.jp is the helping, it means helping out each other in Japanese. Then this website has all kinds of the essential information. If you want to volunteer, they also have the information here. If you want to send donation, if you want to send the relief aid, and then, you know, all those kind of information you can get. So, taskeijapan.jp. Thank you very much, Liz.
There's another person on this call, but I feel like I'm overshadowing them.
No. I'm good. He's gonna be the next guest. He's just standing by. I'm talking to him through the chat. So don't worry about it. So any other stuff that you want to add?
That's my summary.
Okay, cool. So, all right, everyone. So, you know, like Borden, you know, you could go to the North Japan to help people. Like up until last week, because we had a golden week, the holiday season, I didn't encourage people to go up there because I know golden week, everybody takes a vacation and more people go. So actually, North Japan had to stop accepting the volunteer because there were so many people up there. But now, after the Golden Week, now many people went back to work. Now, we need volunteer because even it's second week, as you could see from the Borden's picture on the Facebook, they still have to take care of lots of debris. They still have to need help clean up the houses, especially many elderly people live in the North Japan. So I really want to encourage people to go volunteer now. Like, remember Borden, like first like months of this emergency broadcast, I told them don't go to volunteer now.
Yes, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah,
and I understand the reasons for it.
Yeah, so now I am going to start telling people, please, 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 please spread the word that Japan needs volunteer, but you kind of need the help if you don't understand Japanese culture. But there are many organizations, hands-on, I think hands-on.org is organizing, and the Peace Board Japan, I think, organizing the volunteer, I think. Let me check. So,
well, did you want to answer the questions from the...
Yeah. Oh, yeah, so, yeah, okay, cool. So, is there any question? Who keep flushing the toilet? No one. So...
Yeah, I think it's me, because I live right next to a major road, and the trucks drive by my house, like, every 2 minutes.
Oh, see, oh, okay, that's, okay, got it. Yeah, so...
And my window's open because it was really hot today.
Oh, yeah, it's really... it's kind of hot, too, here, too.
And I can't use the air conditioner.
Why?
Because of saving electricity.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and then, you know, because of the... I need to save the electricity in my area, too. Because... Hamaoka nuclear power plant is going to, you know, kill their nuclear power plant. Then I am in this area, so I will also have I might have to face the schedule blackout too. We'll see. But all right. So
let's look down the question. Where do they put the debris? I have no idea where they put the debris.
They are working on it. They're working on like where to put the debris. I don't know. They're still figuring out right now. So that's the question. They also wanna know the answer. The people in the North Japan also trying to figure out where they put the debris, because this is the unprecedented amount of the debris.
And one person said, they asked if it's getting hot in Japan, and you know, it's getting. There have been a few hot days.
Yeah.
Not hot enough to cause any heat stroke, I don't think, not yet.
Yeah.
Hot enough to make me very annoyed.
It was so humid here, too. It was raining and so humid, and now I'm wearing the short sleeve today, too.
So I wear short sleeves at work.
Yeah.
70% chance of rain today, tomorrow, or the next day.
Okay. Yeah, it's going to be, it's getting the summer time of Japan. Exciting summer coming up.
Oh, I'm dreading it. I'm dreading the summer with no air conditioning.
So, is Tohoku area in the effect zone of typhoon? We just had a typhoon maritime warning in Taiwan. Actually, we do have a heavy rain storm warning in the Tokai area. Actually, it's showing on the news right now on my TV next to it. However, it's not going to touch down the Tohoku, and then I think by the time it hits Japan, it's going to be, they predict that it's going to be downgraded to a tropical storm from typhoon by the time it reached Japan. So
I've been through two typhoon seasons in Kazoo, and there was supposed to be a typhoon on my first day of work.
Okay.
And it came, and it was not like, wasn't anything disastrous. It was just a lot of rain for an hour or two, and some wind, not strong wind.
Okay.
Just, stronger than normal wind.
Okay. Okay, cool. So,
people in shelters, still the same situation for them. People in shelters, I know that the shelter we went to has gotten limited electricity back for their refrigerators to keep food.
Mm.
So that will help them in the summer, because the food will spoil if it gets saved, put outside, stored outside.
I see.
And the like I said, the water truck comes twice a day.
Yeah.
And the people get delivered food once a day, and the volunteer doctors come, and the post office comes, and Sagawa Transport comes. So they're not cut off by any means. They're a little less looked after than some of the bigger shelters, but they're not going to starve to death.
Mm. Yeah. So what they're working on right now is to build the temporary housing so that people no longer have to stay in the shelter anymore.
That's right.
So, Liz, and actually many people start moving into the temporary housing now. So they're now less and less people living in the shelter these days. I didn't get the exact number right now, but that's what's happening. So all right. So Jim, thank you very much. So it has been Jim Borden from Kazoo, Saitama, to talk about his volunteering experience in Golden Week. You can check the people in Tohoku area needs volunteer. If you can speak Japanese, if you have time, I'm more than welcome. I mean, I encourage you to go there, and you kind of need money, unfortunately. But even you don't speak Japanese, get somebody who can speak Japanese and then come to Japan and then help volunteer and stuff too. But as the day proceed, it's not just, it's getting more difficult. The needs is kind of getting diverse. This area needs this kind of help. That area needs that kind of help. So, it's also about the organization and stuff too. So, we need volunteer. We need more volunteer in the North Japan. So, But I mean, actually, this is also my volunteer too, to get people informed of what's going on in the Tohoku area. So, all right. So, yeah. All right. Thank you very much, Jim. And you can stay in and assist me for the next guest, if you could.
Okay.
Yeah. So now we are going to the next guest, Taka-san from Iwaki, Fukushima. Taka-san.
Hi, konbanwa.
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 Konbanwa. Yoroshiku onegai shimasu.
Yoroshiku onegai shimasu.
Taka-san is living in Iwaki, Fukushima right now. So, yeah. So, Taka-san living in Iwaki, Fukushima right now. And then he has been experiencing the, you know, story of what. So, he has the website called I Breathe Iwaki. He started it, this website to I Breathe. iBreezeIwaki.net. He wants to kind of tell the people outside of Iwaki, Fukushima, what is going on in Iwaki. So he is the professional videographer in Iwaki, Fukushima, which is 40 kilometers away from Fukushima nuclear power plant. So I just posted on the social timeline, and then since he's doing this website to tell people what's going on, so I just asked him to join it. じゃあ、タカさん、
はい、
よろしくお願いいたします。
よろしくお願いします。
じゃあタカさん、簡単な自己紹介をよろしくお願いします。
はい、私は福島県いわき市に住んでおります。ビデオカメラマンのビデオの仕事をしている高萩と申します。
はい、Okay, so nice to meet you, everyone. My name is Takahagi, and we call him Taka. That's his surname, last name, Takahagi-san. Then he's working as a videographer in Iwaki, Fukushima. はい、and そのいわき市というところはどこで、その福島の原発から40キロ離れてるっていうことですね。So you live in 40 kilometers away from the Fukushima nuclear power plant ですね。
はい、そうです。
はい、Yes. So today I'm going to ask him to talk about his experience. He's going to share the experience of the day of the Fukushima nuclear power plant. I mean, the earthquake happened, and then what happened? Then Borden, you are welcome to join in to ask him a question too in the middle of the time. Well, you're welcome to interrupt.
Okay.
タカさん、そしたら、まず地震が起こった時から、
はい、
どんな感じなんかっていうのを、説明していただきたいと思うんですけれども、
はい、
どういう感じ、地震が起こった時って何をされてたんですか。So, ちょっと待ちます。タカさん、So I'm going to ask youThe chronologically of what happened in the during the earthquake. What happened the day of the earthquake? What were you doing? じゃあ、震災の時は何されてたんですか？
自宅の仕事をする事務所で、お客様が来ていましたので、 お話をしていました。
Ah. So he was at the time of the earthquake, he was having the meeting with his client at his office. それで。
はい。で、お話ししていたらば、まあ、地震がなったわけですね。
はいはい。So now, then he was talking to a client, then earthquake happened. はいはい。
で、まあ、地震にはもう慣れてますので、まあ、また地震かと思いまして、そのままお話ししてたんですけども、地震の揺れがなかなか止まらない。あと長いんですね。長く続いて、だんだん強くなってきたんですね。それで、あ、これはちょっといつもとは違うぞということを覚えまして。
はい。で、okay. So, so, you know, he always experienced earthquake as usual. But, you know, this time, the length of the earthquake is kind of too long. So, you know, he felt a little bit weird and then something wrong. はい。
でなもういつもと違う大きさなので、そうこうしているうちにもう揺れがひどくなって、立っていられない状況になりました。
So, then as time proceeded, the shake was getting the bigger and bigger, and then until that he wasn't able to stand still. はい。
Stand up.
Stand up, yeah.Keep standing up. はいはい。
机の上のものが倒れそうになったり、モニターは一つ倒れたんですけども、それ以外の本棚を倒れちゃ怖いなと思って、本棚を押さえたり、机に、机を押さえるので、精一杯でしたね。
So, he tried to, What happened? Ah, okay. So he tried to hold the you know the everything start shaking a lot. So he tried to hold the stuff on the desk and try not to fall down and stuff.
So that the books to fall off of his desk and shelves.
Yes. はい。
それでまあ。物が倒れて目の前の物が倒れて机もどんどんぐらぐら揺れてたので、もう非常に怖い恐怖心を覚えました。
Then it's almost like it was really scary moment because the book then everything start falling then stuff. Okay. What? あの恐怖心を覚えましたの前何でしたっけ？
あ、もうそうですね。まあ、揺れがひどくて、あの机がもうぐらぐら動いて、立っていられなくなって、恐怖症を覚えたって感じですね。
あ、okay、わかりました。もう、so the degree of the shake on the table and desk was so much that you know it got point that he got scared and stuff. はい。
はい。で、まあ時間ははっきり覚えてないんですけども、多分2分ぐらいはもう揺れていたと思うんですね。
うん。
はい。
He doesn't believe the how long that it lasted, but it was about two minutes. はい。
それでまあ本震の揺れが、収まって、ただ正直言いまして、いつその事務所から逃げ出していいかがわからないっていうのが本音です。
うん。So, after the main shock finished, you know, the main aftershake finished, but he actually didn't know if he should evacuate from the building or not. はい。
はい、でもうその時点で、コンピューターの電源とかすべて切れてしまいまして停電になりまして、うん で一緒にいたお客様がもう外に出ましょうって僕を促しました。
うん。So by that time the all the electricity was gone. So he told the his client to leave the building. はい。
でオフィス、まあ事務所が鉄筋コンクリートの建物だったので、まあそんな簡単には壊れないだろうと思いながらも。いて中にとどまっていいのか、それとも外に出るべきなのか、非常に不安だったんですけども、外に避難しました。
うん。すいません。
はい、
ちょっと申し。
はい。
It's people having the streaming problem. I'm kind of broadcasting higher quality than yesterday. So, okay. Well.I need to anyway. もすみません、もう一回お願いします。
はい。
He said he didn't want to go outside.
Okay.
外に避難していいかどうか不安だったんですけども、はい、まずお客様と一緒に外に避難しました。
はい。So he didn't want to go outside first, but he went out with the client. Thank you, Borden. はい、どうぞ。
はい。で外マンションの事務所のマンションの外にちょっと広場があったのでそこに移動したんですけども、その時も近くのオフィスとか住宅からやはり同じように人がたくさん避難して出てきてたんですけども、とにかく余震が頻繁に起こったんですね。
So that he tried, he, まずどこに避難、自宅ですよね。
まず自宅前の広場に。
So he first evacuated to the 広場。公園。公園それは。
駐車スペースですね。
So he just evacuated to the parking lot nearby his house, near his home. But the aftershock keep happening over and over. はい。
はい。ただその駐車場のスペースも四方を見ると電柱が立っていまして、でいつこの電柱が倒れてきてもおかしくないぐらいの余震が続いて、30秒とか1分おきぐらいに余震が頻発してたような気がしました。
30分、
30秒とか1分、
30秒
間隔がそのぐらいの、
the amount of the aftershock is like every 30 seconds or every minuteで、長さはどんな感じぐらいですかね。
もう長さはそうですね、30秒ぐらいのものもあれば10秒ぐらいのものもあれば、いろんな長さがありました。
It's about like aftershock, those continuous constant aftershock happening every 30 seconds, 1 minute, it's about 10 seconds or 30 seconds long. All various kinds of the aftershock kept happening all day long after the live cast. Hi.
And he was worried that the telephone poles were going to fall over.
Oh, okay. Hi.
Hi. で、今度は外にいるので、僕のマンションを外から見てるわけですけども、そのマンションとその隣に木造住宅があるんですね。瓦屋根の。で、僕のマンションも余震でまた外から見てるとすごい揺れてるんですけども、その隣の木造住宅はもっと今にも倒れそうなぐらいの揺れをこう外から目の当たりにするんですね。
じゃあその余震もすごく
余震も結構
大きいのがあったってことですね。
そうですね。
So those one couple of the aftershock was very strong as well. Then from the parking lot, he was able to He was able to see his own apartment and also the wood housing next to his apartment, and then he was clearly able to see how his own apartment building and how the wooden housing building next to the apartment was shaking constantly after the aftershock too. はい。
でこの時にまた外に避難してるんですけども、やはり恐怖心が継続したのは、余震のどんどん頻発することと、 あとその揺れの強さ、
うん、
あと周りから周りの人々も出てきてるんですけども、みんな一様にこのなんていうんですかね、もう顔面は非常にこう蒼白に近い感じで、
うん、
そういった意味でその鳴り止まないことに対する不安ですね、
うん、
うん、それがありました。
So, so there are many people many people excuse me many people around by him was also felt scared too, you know, so everybody's face was, you know, pale, and then, you know, worry about this continuous, the amount of the aftershock. もうじゃあ広場にはどんだけ いられたんですか？
広場にはですね、多分、40分とか1時間は多分いたと思います。
He was staying at those parking lot about 40 minutes after, you know. じゃあ、地震が起こって外に出て、
はい、
で広場に戻って、じゃあ広場にその40分ぐらいいたっていうことは、
はい、
大体5時6時ぐらいまではそこら辺にいらっしゃったっていうことですかね。
発生が2時46分だったので、
うん、
そうですね、今お話して思い出ししたのは、
うん、
その後やはりこう自宅の方がやっぱり気になったので、
うん、
もう一回戻って中を確認したりとか、
うん
うん、あとまたやっぱり建物の中危険だよっていうことなので、
うん、
外に行ってパーキングの車の中でお客様と2人でラジオをつけて聞きながら、
うん、
でその時ちょうど雪が降ってきたんですね。
ああ、じゃあすいません。 So after, soon after the earthquake, I just asked him how long he was at the parking lot, but he told me that once, so he left his office, then came back to his home and check out his own apartment, but the building was supposed to be dangerous, so he went to his car and then listening to the radio, and then you know it starts snowing too. Hi.
Hi. The車の中で、ラジオの情報を聞きながら、
うん、
とにかく、まあ、余震が続いているので、とにかくどうにもできないので車の中でしばらく待機してました、
うん、So he just you know, starts snowing and you know, they don't know what they should do, so pretty much they are waiting inside of the car. で、それでだ広場の車の中にいらっしゃったということですね。
そうです、広場の車の中。
だから駐車場の、
はい、
駐車場の、車の中にいらっしゃった
んですね。そうです、
そうです。 OK、はい、So they were inside of the parking lot. だから他の方 がみんな真っ青って言われてたので、外におったのかなとか思ったんですけど。
そうですね、最初逃げ出した時にはみんな、同じパーキングのスペースに、
うん、
まあ、みんなあ、まあ、真っ青な顔で、
うん、
不安な表情で僕も含めて立って、
うん、
周りの揺れを、まあ、なんていうか、そこで過ごしたということですね。
わ、うん、かりました。 Yeah, so including other residents from the apartment building. So after that, yeah, その後、家に戻られて、その夜はどういうふうに過ごされたんですか？
ですね、まず家内が、職場から早めに帰ってきまして、
うん、
で子供2人いるので子供2人を保育所に迎えに行ったんですね、
うんうん、So first night, his wife came back from home early, and then they have two children, so they went to take collect their children from the kindergarten. はい、
はい、で自宅から保育所までは約2キロぐらい離れてるんですが、
うん、
そこに行くまでの状況が、
うん、
ブロック塀が倒壊してたり、
うん、
古い住宅が倒壊してたり、
うん、
道路が陥没あるいは波打ってたりしてました。
うん、So they were on the way to the kindergarten to, they saw many old houses had a damage, and then some wall, block wall was corrupt. Some, 波打ってるっていうのはもう亀裂が入ってるっていうか、どういう波打ってるでしょうかね。
そうですね、あのデコボコになってる。
Oh, so the, the road was bumpy and stuff. So, Liz, were the broadcast telling them anything, where to go, where not to go about tsunami? Yeah, あの、その時のラジオの、状況、ラジオの放送とかはどういうことを言われ、その避難情報とかはどういうことを言われてたんですか？
まずですね、地震発生直後に、大津波警報が発令されまして、うんうん、で、とにかく、海岸線の人は避難してくれと、高台に避難してくれと。
Mm. So first of all, Liz, the broadcast says that because of there's a big tsunami warning, just the people in the coastal line must evacuate. Yeah, はい。
それで、まあとにかくその避難してくれということと、余震がまだ継続してたので、そのブロック塀の近くには近づかないとか、
うん、
電信柱の近くに近づくなとか、
うん、
あととにかく慌てずに落ち着いて行動してくださいということがもう連続的に放送されてました、う
ん、So continuously the broadcast was telling not to stand next to the brick wall and because it might collapse from the aftershockAnd then, you know, just don't get close, in addition to don't get close to the, you know, coastal line because of the tsunami and stuff. Then going back to his story of, you know, he went to, on the way to kindergarten, he collects his kids and then,それで、その、帰りましたよね。で、もうお子さんをお迎えに行ってから、もう家に帰られたんですね。
そうです。
はい、で、その夜はもちろん、ライフラインってどんな感じでした、その時は。
ですね、たまたまうちのエリア、
うん、
うちのあるエリアは、電気は通じてたんですね。
ああ。
電気は通じてたんですね。
ああ。
で、ガスと水道はストップ。
うん。
はい。
So, how about I just ask him, how was the lifeline in Iwaki, Fukushima? そこはちょっと、海岸からは何キロぐらい、10キロ何キロぐらいでしたっけ、6キロぐらいでしたっけ。
そうですね、10キロぐらいありましたかね。
10キロかね、10キロ、はい、はい。So, he lived like 10 kilometers away from the ocean. So, it's about 6 miles, 10 kilometers away from the ocean. So, he didn't get affected by the tsunami.But I just asked him a lifeline question, like if he has electricity or... Yes, he did have electricity, but he did not have the water or gas for the first night. あれ、電気消えてたんじゃなかったでしたっけ？
ですね、一時的に停電してたんですね。
うん、
思い出しました。
あ、じゃあ戻った。その夜には戻ったってことですね。
ですね、夜の2時間ぐらい、
うん、
なんか保安点検のために、
うん、
停電したと。
うん、
ただこのエリアだけのことであって、
うん、
いわき市内ほとんどは、
うん、
停電しているエリアが多かったです。
So luckily he was living in a lucky spot that he did have a shortage of the black small amount of blackout, but he didn't have to suffer from the blackout so much from his area. Okay, cool. So じゃあ、その夜は、じゃあ、ご家族、ちょっと、ご家族、let's go to the family question. So, he himself didn't have much of the damage in terms of the earthquake and then, tsunami. But how about his family? じゃあ、ご家族については、どんな感じでしたでしょうかね。
まず子供たちは、まあ、地震とにかく大きかったので、とにかくそのもう怖いという恐怖心が、もうずっとあったので、余震が来るたびにも僕たちにしがみついてくる感じでしたね。
おいくつですかね、今。
5歳の男と2歳の女の子です。
He has a 5-year-old boy and then 2-year-old girl. But, you know, especially they were scared of the aftershock. So whenever aftershock happens, they come to him or his wife, because they got so scared about aftershock. 今でもそうですか？
今でも地震が来ると非常に怖がりますね。
So even now he get so scared too. 他のご家族とかはどんな感じでしょうか？
他の家族と言いますと、
ご親戚とか。
親戚の家は、私の家内の家は、海岸、もうまさに海岸線沿いなので、床上浸水、津波被害に遭いました。
So, his wife, house, parents' house was in the coastal line. So, yes, his wife, parents' house got swapped by tsunami. However, his house wasn't damaged. He just got just flooded by tsunami. So, how did they calm his kids down? It must be 読者の方から質問なんですけども、どうやってお子さんあやしてるんですかって。
ですね、あやす、要はもう抱っことかしてれば子供は安心なので、とにかく抱っこして、あと、なんて言うんですかね、高い高いやってあげたり、まあ、普段遊んでいるように、こう、体を使って、お馬さんやったり、そういうことで、恐怖心をちょっと忘れるようなことありました。
So, Pochagi, so what he usually do to calm them down is that, they try to hold them, hug them, and 高い高い。
Rock them?
Rock them.
Rock them in their arms.
And then, so make sure that, keep just cheering them up and make sure they have the physical interaction to keep them kind of have fun, having kind of have fun and stuff. So that's how he tried to calm kids down all the time. And his kids are still scared of the aftershock. So then his family, his wife, parents' house got flooded by tsunami. じゃあ、床上浸水だけれども、家が全壊したというわけじゃないんですよね。
たまたま私の家内の実家は、たまたまちょっとこう条件が良かったんですね。ちょっとこう周りの住宅よりも、1メーターぐらいちょっとこう土が盛ってあったり、あとブロック塀が堅牢だったので、ただその周りの家々は、1階がもう津波で、壊されちゃったり、結構もうひどい状態でしたね。
So, luckily, his wife's parents' house was like had a was 1 meter taller than any other houses surrounded by. So, he got a little bit of the flooding, but Other houses surrounded by got you know soaked by the entire first story of the house was swept away by tsunami and stuff. So yes, one of his family members' house got swept by tsunami and stuff. Yeah, Liz hug and the rocks always helps and stuff. So let me ask about the information question. So first night, especially, how did you get the information from? そのじゃあタカさん、
はい、
その地震とかの情報、最初の夜とかの、情報とかはどんな、どうやってゲットされてたんですか？
ですね、うちはたまたま電気が、ほとんど使えてたので、
うん、
テレビをつけっぱなしに、一晩中つけっぱなしで、
うん、So, but luckily, his house had electricity, so he kept turning on the TV. So TV was the main source of the information for the first night. But internet とか使えたんで、How about internet? Internet とか使えたんですか？
Internet は使える環境ではあったんですが、インターネットで情報を検索しようという気にはならなかったです。
うん。So, he was able to use the internet, but he didn't think about using the internet to collect the information. それはなんでなんですか？
ですね、余震が結構まだまだあったので、うん、パソコンに向かって腰を据えてこう検索するような余裕がなかったというのが事実ですね。
うん。So because of there were so many continuous aftershock, he didn't feel like he was like he had a mentally ready to sit down in front of the computer to type on the keyboard. じゃあもうそのテレビ見てる時っていうのは、
はい、
もうなんていうのかな。もういつでも逃げれる、ある意味じゃあいつでも逃げれるようにって感じな感じで見てたっていうことですね。
そうです。
So I just asked him that. So he said that the reason why he only rely on the TV was because because you know if he used the internet, he needs to sit down and then he needs to type, but if he watched the TV, you know, he can watch the TV standing up, you know, whatever, so that he's ready to like run away, like if he watched the TV and stuff. That's kind of makes sense. Yeah, so you can watch TV from the distance and standing up. You don't have to have keyboard in front of you. So, hi, hi. Yeah, okay. So let's go to the new, you know, main topic, kind of the main topic of the day. So, nuclear power plant incident. じゃあ、そろそろ、原発のことに行きたいと思うんですけれども、
はい、
じゃあ、そのまず原発の When did you hear about nuclear power plant issue first? 原発のことを一番最初に知ったのはいつ頃なんでしょうかね？
ですね、子供たち、要は子供たちを連れて帰って、家に着いてからはずっとテレビつけっぱなしにしたんですね。
うん。
で、そうしましたらば、その原発でトラブルが起こってるようなニュースが徐々に報道され始まったんですね。
Mm. So once he returned home from kids from the kindergarten, the TV is still reporting that nuclear power plant is having an issue. それ第1日目ですよね。
そうです。地震の日の夕方以降ですね。
Evening of the starting the evening of the March 11th. So he start hearing the there are something wrong with the nuclear power plant. それで、はい。
その日の、地震起きた日の夜7時過ぎには、
うん、
あの政府が緊急事態原子原発に対する緊急事態宣言をされてですね。
At the 7 p.m. on the March 11th, the Japanese government issued a state of emergency for the nuclear power plant. はい。
でそれからもう間もなくして。いわゆる避難指示ですね。半径例えば2キロとか3キロの住民に対する避難命令とかいう形で具体的に原発が危険だというアクションが見えてきたんですね。
So、they start seeing that 2 to 3 kilometers radius of the nuclear power plant. They order the evacuation order. So he now starts seeing the kind of danger by seeing the Japanese government issue the evacuation order and stuff. はい。
はい。で、まあそういう状態で、あ、もうこれはちょっと大変なことになっていくんだなっていうのを感じながら、あとはもうあれですね、とにかく、テレビの方はもう原発を映しているような、映像と、あと各地の津波被害の甚大さを報道する。
うん、
ニュースばかりでした。
あ、じゃあ、そのテレビはそんなに原発の報道をしてなかったってことですね、最初の日は。
そうですね、結局、そうですね、まあ、原発も結構されてたんですけども、
うん、
要は緊急事態宣言とかいうことになってから、だんだんだんだんこう原発に、
うん、
クローズアップされるようになってきた感じですね。
うん、So, since the state of the emergency, he starts seeing the news, but also, you know, all kinds of the tsunami news was coming in place and stuff too. So, yeah. それがひとまず最初の日ってことですよね。
そうですね。
最初の夜は。So, that's pretty much it, the first night of the day. So, the aftershock continuously happened. And then, news of the Fukushima nuclear power plant situation started coming up. State of the emergency has been issued by Japanese government. So, he felt, he started feeling the uneasiness.Over the nuclear power plant. じゃあその夜って寝れたんですか？
その夜はですね、またいつ地震が発生するか分かんない、まあ、余震はずっと絶え間なく頻発してたんですけども、
うん、
とにかくもうすぐ逃げられるように、うん、そんな状態で服を着たまま寝てました、
うん、じゃあ寝ることはできたんですか、ね、
寝ることはまあとにかく寝ないと今度なんていうんですか行動できなくなってしまうので、
うん、
子供たちを寝かせながら、うん、自分たちもまあ要は横になってたぐらいですよね、
うん
うん、その完全にこう寝入ることはできなかったですね。
わかりました。 So I just asked him how if he was able to sleep that night, first night, March 11th, then but he still wear the like a clothes, no pajama, just a clothes. He kept wearing the clothes so that he could evacuate right away. Aftershock continuously happened.So he wasn't, then he tried to lay down, he tried to rest. However, because aftershock continuously happened, and so he wasn't really able to sleep that night. じゃあ、2日目の、so let's turn it into the March 11th topic. So, I think then he's going to decide to you know, evacuate because of the nuclear power plant. So let me go ask him what is the story, how he decided to evacuate and stuff. じゃあ、そしたら避難するまでの話をちょっと詳しくゆっくりと教えていただけますでしょうか。
はい。翌日12日に土曜日には、
うん、
近くに親戚がいるので、
うん、
そこの状況が心配だったので、見に行きましたらば、家にもう亀裂が入ってたり、あとガラスが割れたりで大変な形だったので、それをこう手伝いに応急修理というか応急整理ですよね、
So second day, March 12th, so he went to his relative house. His house had a crack, broken glasses. So the next day he went to his relative house to help and stuff. はい。
それでその時にすでにですね、コンビニ、周辺のコンビニストアとか、あとガソリンスタンドは、
うん、
ほとんど閉まった状態ですね。物がなくなって。
Mm. On the March 12th, then so when around that, Iwaki Fukushima, no convenience store, no gas station was open because nothing was available. はい。
で、まずこんな状況になったので食料を買わないといけないと思いまして、
mm.
スーパーマーケット行ったんですけども。
So this, under these circumstances, he think that he need to buy food. So he went to the supermarket. はい。
すぐ食べれるもの、調理しなくていいようなもの。
うん。
パンであるとか、豆腐。
うん。
納豆。
うん。
牛乳。
うん。
そういったあと缶詰。
うん。
そういった食料は、
うん。
ほとんどなくなってましたね。
So at the supermarket.Like any food that no don't require like cooking, bread, milk, tofu, and that kind of stuff, or also the canned food, all those stuff were gone from the supermarket. はい。
まあとりあえずそれはなくても別なもので代用できるものを買って。
うん
12日はまた家に戻って過ごしました。
So anyway, he tried to manage to buy some stuff from the supermarket. Then he went back home, and then he spent the night in his house. はい。
でこの日の夕方前、そうですね、3時半頃に、原発1号機が爆発したんですね。
12時の1でしたっけ
午後3時半頃ですね。
So, so at about 3:30 p.m. on the March 12th, so the first nuclear reactor building got blasted. So, はい。
で、さらに、実質的に爆発しちゃったので、さらにその報道に関しては、もう原発がメインの
うん
ニュース映像ばかりになりまして、
はい、
いよいよ大変なことになってしまったなという気持ちで、
はい
まずは過ごしてました。
So you know, because of the nuclear power plant, you know, the first reactor got blasted. Most of the news, the mainstream news, became.You know, talking about the nuclear power plant. So he now start thinking that, okay, nuclear power plant is becoming the serious stuff. はい。
で、そこで気になったのが、
うん
原発が爆発したことによって、放射性物質の拡散であるとか汚染が、深刻であろうと思うんですが、
うん、
政府の発表では、
うん
それほど深刻じゃない感じだったので、
うん、
これでいいのかなって思いましたね。
So, you know, although the first reactor's building blasted, Japanese government didn't say that radiation leak was not that bad, you know, but he started doubting about all the release of the Japanese government. You know, he started worrying about the radiation leakage and stuff. For you guys, you know, Taka on the Skype, we have a Taka on Skype. He's live, joining us live on Yokoso News from Iwaki, Fukushima. Iwaki is located, where he lives is like 40 kilometers southwest from Fukushima nuclear power plant. And then he's telling us, right now he's telling us the story of the March 12th, the day after the earthquake happened, live from, Yokkaichi, Japan, and Iwaki, Fukushima, and with Borden from Kazuo, Saitama, kinda, from the earlier guest. はい、時々こんな感じですいませんけども、はい、なんか、なんちゅうの、はい、説明し直すんで申し訳ないです。はい、で、それからどんな感じで、
まず、頭に湧いてきたのは、チェルノブイリとか、スリーマイルアイランドのことが頭に浮かんだので、
うん、
政府発表のコメントで本当にいいのだろうか、非常になんかこう信用できないような気がしてきたんですね。
So next, you know, what he came up in his mind was a Chernobyl and then Three Miles Island incident, and then he, you know, he like from the pastHe, you know, from the past incident, he wasn't really able to trust the Japanese government as much. はい。
まあでも政府がそう言っているのだから、あまりこう神経質になって、行動を起こすのもどうかなという思いと、もう一つはガソリンがないので、はい、遠くに避難することもできない。
So, but, But I mean, he even he thinks that he wasn't getting enough information. He wanted to evacuate, but there were not enough gasoline, so he wasn't even able to evacuate farther away because of the lack of the gas. はい。
で、まあそんな形でその日は過ぎていきました。
So that's how he spent the second day.Of the second day of the March 12th. はい。
はい。で、13日日曜日になって、
はい。
私の実家ですね。
うん。
約40キロ離れてるんですけども、うん、そこに、水とガスコンロを取りに向かいました。
So, next day, March 13th, Sunday, his parents' house is located 40 kilometers away. So he went there to get more water because water ran out, and also the portable gas burner. はい。
で、まあその日は、そうですね、実家へ行って水とガスコンロをもらってきて、
うん、
で、実家は田舎の方なので、うん、田舎の方のガソリンスタンドは多分ガソリンがあるだろうと思って行ったんですけども、うん、隣接地域まで足を運んだんですが、すべてガソリンスタンドは閉店でした。
うん、So, you know, because his parents' house was also already 40 kilometers away, he thought that the gas station in that area was available, but even so, he's near his parents' house 40 kilometers away from 40 kilometers away from the his house. That area was also not available. Many, you know, even though more countryside that his parents lived. はい。
で、まあ、そういうことでガソリンも入れられずに、また平の自宅に戻ってきました。Mm.
So, you know, he still no gas. He wasn't able to get more gas, and he came back home again. はい。
はい。で、14日月曜日になりまして。
The next day, March 14th of the March, Monday. はい。
はい。で、妻は職場へ。
はい。
で、子供たちは、保育所に連れて行こうと思って、準備してたんですね。
So in the morning of the March 14th, Monday, his wife was going back to work, and then he was getting ready to send their kids to the kindergarten in the morning. はい。
そして、午前11時ごろに、
はい、
ちょうどこれから保育園に子供を連れて行こうとした瞬間に、
うん、
3号機の爆発が。
So in the morning of the March 14th, when he was about to send their kids to the kindergarten, the third nuclear reactor, the building, got the blast, hydrogen blast on the March 14th. はい。
で、1号機に続いて3号機の爆発なので、という感じですよね。
So in, you know, the in addition to the first nuclear reactor's explosion, hydrogen explosion, that's another hydro explosion, hydro blast of the third reactor. So he's again shocked. He's really shocked. はい。
He said,
"Hey." そこから行政の方から。
はい。
自宅退避、
はい、
的な感じのな情報が流れてきたんですね。
So, then around that time, he looks like the government, local government, ordered the like curfew. They, you know, curfew or boarding. Is that my wording correct? The curfew?
Sorry, I was distracted. What's the Japanese word?
自宅退避。Taihi means like you know, you must stay inside of the, you better、yeah. stay inside of the house.
Yeah, that, yeah, that's a curfew.
Curfew, right? Yeah, so daylight
curfew. You have to be home at a certain time.
Yeah, but all day curfew, kind of, order, yeah.
Oh, stay, the, oh yeah, the, yeah. That, the stay indoor orders?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
For the 20 to 30 kilometer
yeah,
zone?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's the, that was called the stay inside order.
Stay inside order, no curfew.
No, curfew just means you have to be home at a certain time.
Oh, okay. Okay, I'm sorry. Stay indoor order. Okay, stay indoor. I kind of kept saying curfew during the emergency broadcast, but it's okay. はい、すいません。
はい。で、家内が職場に行ったわけですけども、昼過ぎぐらいには早めに帰ってきて、で、結局もうまた軟禁状態、要は、うちに自宅退避ですよね。
だからもうお子さんも
連れて行けずに、
はい。ええ、so his wife came back home by noon, around noon from work, and then his kids couldn't go to the kindergarten because of the stay indoor order. So he just they were just you know inside of their house in Iwaki. So はい。
でもこの頃になるともう絶対ここにいたのでは、
うん、
放射能に汚染されてしまうんじゃないかという危機感があったので、
はい、
もうとにかくまずは自宅実家の方に避難したかったんですけども、うん、ガソリンがない、
うん、So at this point you know he was really worried about the radiation leak you know radiationbecause, you know, the stay indoor order, the two blast, but he wanted to evacuate, but he didn't have a gas. はい。
はい。で、まあ、その日は不安に思いながらも、移動できないので、結局そのまま家にいながら次の日を迎えました。
So on the March 14th, even though he wanted to do something, but he couldn't do anything. So pretty much he just spent a day inside of his house on the March 14th. So now let's move on to the March 15. Everyone, this is Katz from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. We are live interviewing with Taka. He's the videographer in Iwaki, Fukushima, 40 kilometers away from the nuclear power plant. And he's telling us the day-to-day story of what happened after the earthquake and tsunami and Fukushima incident. He's telling us how he spent, his 1 month after the nuclear power plant and stuff too. And now going to the story of the evacuation, how he decided to evacuate and stuff. はい。で、それで15日ですね。
15日火曜日に入りまして、うん、で、原発が爆発して、
うん、
初めての雨が降る予報が出たんですね、うん、で雨が降ることによって、移動していいのか悪いのか、
うん、
情報がよくわからなかったので、
うん、
自宅に退避してたんですけども
So, March 15th、The weather forecast said that it was going to rain that day on March 15th on Tuesday. And, this was going to be the first day that it was going to rain since the, blast. So, they didn't know what they should do because of the rain. はい。
で、その15日の朝ですね。
はい。
今度は2号機と4号機でそれぞれ爆発するんですね。
So in the morning of the 15th, there was a blast on the second nuclear reactor suppression room and then also the spent fuel pool of the fourth nuclear reactor. はい。
はい。それで、もう厳しいなというふうな心、要はもうとにかく不安な気持ちになりまして。
So on the March 15th, he, because of all the additional blast, he start getting really worried. はい。
車の中に入っているガソリンだけで、
うん、
まずは実家へ避難しようと。
So although he wanted to evacuate further places, but gas in his car wasn't so much left. So he just decided to move, try to go to his parents, evacuate. He decided to evacuate to his parents' house, which is 40 kilometers away from his house in Iwaki. Still in Iwaki, but slightly farther away. So, だから、ご自宅が、40キロですよね。
はい。
で、ご両親の家が60キロぐらいですかね。
50キロぐらいですね。
So, where he lives is the 40 kilometers away from the Fukushima nuclear power plant, but his parents' house is 50 kilometers away. Only 10 kilometers away, but, because he doesn't have enough gas, so he just only thought that it's better than nothing. So he decided to evacuate to his parents' house in Fukushima. はい。
はい。で、その頃にはですね、
うん、
携帯電話の方に、要はチェーンメールですね、
うん、
変な情報がたくさん入ってくるような時期がありました。
So around that time, he started receiving all kinds of the chain mail. Is that chain mail right word, Borden?
Yes.
Okay, chain mail, the rumor emails, cell phone emails, text message. Yes, I.
で、まあそういったチェーンメールとかどんどん入ってくるので、
うん、
まあそれはすべて非常にこう怖い内容のメールなんですね。
うん、
なものですから、家内は非常にこう精神的に不安定に、うん、陥ってました。
So, all the contents of the chain mail was so scaring. So, he decided, especially his wife, he got really mentally stressed and distorted, I mean stressed and hard from this chainmail too. はい。
She was going crazy.
Yeah, she was pretty much going crazy. はい。
はい。それでまあ、そうですね。とにかく入ってるガソリンだけで移動しまして、
うん、
田舎の実家に着いたらばですね、
うん、
まあ、家族が増えるので、
うん、
家も大きい家なので、
うん、
あの非常に安心したことを覚えてます。
So once he moved to his parents' house, because his parents' house was kind of large house, and more family members, you know, his parents' family were there. So once they were able to get to their house, more people were together. So he remembered that he was able to relax more.はい、
はい、でまあその日はただ実家には行ったんですが、
うん、
実家でしばあのそのままいようという気はなかったんですね。
Although he went to his parents' house, he wasn't thinking about staying his parents' house for a long time. はい、
両親を連れて東京方面、要は関東方面に避難しようと考えてました。
So what he was thinking about is he also wants to take his parents to then evacuate to more farther, like Tokyo area. はい。
はい。で、まあ、着いた日の夜から、まあ、一夜明かして、16日になりまして。
うん。So on March 15th, he got to his parents' house and he spent the night and turned to March 16th. はい。
両親を何とか説得しまして。
He was able to convince his parents. はい。
はい。で、夕方までに荷物を積んで、なかったガソリンも、
うん、
何とかこうかき集めて。
うん。So on the March 16th, he tried to pack everything, and then he managed to collect enough gasoline, and then he was able to, then, yes, so he was ready to leave on the March 16th. はい。
はい。で、夕方には、
うん、
いわき市を出発しまして、
うん、
その日の夜中ですね。
うん、
17日にちょうど日が変わる直前に、
うん、
神奈川県川崎市まで避難しました。うん、
So he was able to departure in the evening of the March 16th, and then he was his you know his
he arrived in Kanagawa, Kawasaki.Just yeah. as day was breaking on the next day.
Yeah, so it's like midnight of the March 16th, the night of the March 16th, yeah.
Not dawn?
Dawn. 夜中ですよ、深夜ですよね。
深夜です。
So it took them about 6-7 hours. 6時間、7時間ぐらいですね。
そうですね。
So 6-7 hours drive to Kanagawa, Kawasaki, Kanagawa.Where the, その神奈川の川崎の家っていうのは
一戸建てですね。
どなたなんですか
何でしょうか、すみません。
親戚、その避難されたところは
家内の弟の家です。
So, where he evacuated to was his wife, brother's.Place in Kawasaki, Kanagawa. So they were able to evacuate and then spend a couple days there. So everyone, again, this is Katz from Yokoso News with Taka from Iwaki, Fukushima. Taka is the videographer in Iwaki, Fukushima, which is located 40 kilometers away from Fukushima nuclear power plant. And then it was also joining us, which the earlier guest, you can also check our archive, how he went to volunteer in the north. So he's telling us his life, you know, experience story of how he spent the first months of the nuclear power plant incident, how he evacuated and stuff. And yes, so So pretty much next week, 1 week from the March 16th, he spent a you know, he spent the time in the Kawasaki Kanagawa, where his relative house. で、それから避難してからどんな感じでしょうか。
避難してからは、全くその川崎という、あ、川、まず川崎についてびっくりしたのは、うん、川崎でもガソリンスタンドで、渋滞が起こってました。
So what I was surprised by it was that when he got to Kawasaki, the gas station was also full, jammed when he arrived Kawasaki. はい。
あとはスーパーマーケットでも、牛乳は一人一パックとか、
うん、はい、
あと、うん、そうですね、物によってはないということがあったのでびっくりしました。
He also was surprised at the supermarket of Kawasaki itself too, that many of the, the product were also run out too. はい、
はい、それで、まあ、それでもやはり川崎に住んでいる人々の雰囲気というのは全く平穏な生活で、非常にこうリラックスして過ごすことができました。
Mm. So although, you know, there are some stuff like gasoline or the shortage of the food and stuff, the people in Kawasaki, Kanagawa was much more calm than the situation of the Fukushima, so they were able to relax more in Kawasaki. はいはい。
で、まあそういった形でお世話になってたんですけども。うん、
あ、ちょっといいですか。はい、すいません。Harry Kovir, how were the road condition on the way to Kanagawa? お一人質問、ハワイから質問なんですけれども、はい、その避難する時の道の状態とかどんな感じだったんですか。
ですね、実は、
うん、
あ、道の状態、
うん、
道の状態は、僕は高速道路、
うん、
をメイン、高速道路をずっと高速道路で移動しました。
うん、
で、その高速道路は、
うん、
橋のある部分
は
全て段差になってました。
うん、So, there was a... So, he took an expressway. でも、通れたんですね。
ですね、橋のところは段差になってるので、
うん、
極端な話で、10センチ20センチの段差になって、まあ、場所によっては陥没して、
うん、
車線規制されてたところもあるんですが、うん、低速で通行することが可能で、
うん、
高速道路がフリーになってました。
あ、そうなんや。So, when he was going to evacuate to Kanagawa, he mainly took the expressway. However, the road condition there was kind of rough, especially where the bridge is. The gap in between the bridge and the road had a, how do you say more than, like there were 10 to 20 centimeter
bumps.
Yeah, bumps. It became the bumps because of the earthquake. It raised or it sunk or something. And also some part of the expressway had a hole and stuff. So, because for the, because for the people who wants to evacuate, you know, expressway was open and then it was free of charge. はいはい、ありがとうございました。じゃあメインはもうじゃあ、もうノロノロ運転、渋滞って感じですかね。
あ、ごめんなさい。説明が足りなかったです。
はい。
高速道路は、
うん、
地震によって完全に通行止めになってたんですね、
うん、
ただ、事態が事態になったということなので、
うん、
高速道路を避難する人は、
うん、
自分の責任のもとに、
うん、
無料で使っていいですよとなったんです。
あ、
それは僕らが 避難する直前にそういうことになったんです。
ああ、なるほどね。
はい、それまだ通行止めで。
いや、そうですよね。
はい、
僕もずっと報道では通行止めって聞いてたんで。
そうです。通行止めです。
うん、
ただ実際は避難者がだんだん出てきたので、
うん、
実はですね、僕らが行動する前の段階で避難行動をしてた人たちは、
うん、
高速道路使えないから一般道で峠越えとか、
うん、
ひどい思いをして移動してた人たちがたくさんいたんですね。
ああ、なるほどね。
ええ。
I ask him a question because I've known that from the mainstream media on like all the Tohoku Expressway was supposed to be shut down. It's ever since the March 11th, but I wonder why he was able to use the expressway. So he just told me that. So first couple of days, yes, Tohoku Expressway was closed. However, many people started to evacuate, so many people used the surface street, and then it was really rough, much worse than expressway, damaged expressway. But right before he decided to evacuate, he was lucky. So Tohoku Expressway said that although it is supposed to be closed, they decided to let people to pass through with their own responsibility. So, they were able to use those bumpy expressway to evacuate. So they were able to evacuate a little bit quicker than previous people who wasn't able to use the expressway. はいはい、ありがとうございます。じゃあそんな感じでまた申し訳ないですけれども、戻りましょう。
はい、
その川崎でそのずっと過ごされてたわけなんですけれども、
はい、
ちょっとお待ちください。So now let's go back to the question of how you know he went to the Kawasaki Kanagawa to spend the you know evacuated and spend the day. So let's hear the story afterwards. So それでからどんな感じでしょうかね。
とりあえず避難指示が30キロまでしかならないので、
うん、
原発 周辺30キロまでしか避難指示入らないので、うん、その外側のエリアというのは商業活動が継続されてたわけですね、
うん、
なものですから戻らないわけにいかない状況になってしまったんですね、
うん、So, so he was because he even he wasaway he evacuated he lived 40 kilometers away from the nuclear power plant as you guys know the evacuation order or stay indoor order was placed within 30 kilometers zone so he still liveHe in the 40 kilometers away, so his all the business is supposed to open and stuff. So he was kind of in the circumstances that he kind of need to go back. はいはい。
はい。まあそういうビジネスのこともありましたし、もう一つはメンタルな部分で、やはりこうお世話にずっとなってるのがやっぱり辛いんですね。
うん、そう。
要は何もできない。
うん、そう、そうは、だそれはもう避難してるからってことですよね。
そうですね。
そうは、you know, when he was evacuating, you know, he was away from the his house.He still have his job as a videographer, and then you know he, but he couldn't do anything if he were away. So, he also got a little bit frustrated too. はいはい。
はい。それで、まあ、避難したのですが、1週間川崎でお世話になって、3月の24日ですね、に、原発の方も状態が小康状態になってしまったので、24日にいわきに戻りました。
So, because he was, you know, he is living 40 kilometers away outside of the evacuation order or stay indoor order. And then after a week, situation at the nuclear power plant, it's getting more stabler. So, he decided to come back.To the he decided to come back to Iwaki. じゃあそんな感じですね。
はい。
So that's so ever since それからはもう簡単にじゃあもうある意味普通に仕事を始めたというかお子さん、
仕事は止まってしまったので。うんそうですね、かみさんは職場が、継続してましたので、平常通りに、活動しな、まあ、仕事に行かなければいけない状況でした。
So, yeah, so his wife,、his wife workplace resumed working too, so he had to resume, come back and work and stuff too. So, since the March 24th, and then he came back, and then kind of.Business as usual situation. Although he is the videographer in Iwaki, many of his work got canceled. So, you know, he didn't have much of the work as a videographer. But, you know, so, もちろんお仕事はなかったかもしれませんけども、ある意味普通な生活じゃないと思いますけれども普通な生活に戻りつつあるような
感じというか、そうですね、普通の生活をしなければいけない、要は社会活動は、100% ダウンしてるわけではないので、例えば、市役所とか、あと、直接被害のなかった企業は企業活動を継続してましたので、
you know, although the, you know, it wasn't 100% back normal, of course, but he's surrounded by his place where the place, especially the place where it didn't get affected by tsunami and stuff, the company business. They were still trying to do the business there and stuff. So, you know, the people in Iwaki, many people in Iwaki, including the city hall, they were kind of doing the stuff too. So, はい、そんな感じですね。So, more story comes, we are going to ask Taka.To tell us what's so, I'm now open to any question to Taka. So, people, you are welcome to ask the question to Taka about the situation and stuff too. But let me start asking a question about his opinion on stuff. But Liz.The question from Liz, how did he encounter the same road condition going back? そんな感じ、帰るときは、その、はい、道とか、そういうのはどんな感じだったんですか？
道路はですね、通行止め、ごめんなさい、道路はですね、通行止めは解除されてたんですね。ただ、あくまでも、道路はそうですね、復旧工事の終わってない箇所も多々ありましたので、やはり段差が激しく、 あと、避難のための移動ということで、フリーに使える状態でした。
There on the way back, there's still some bumpy places. There are some places that was doing the construction to restore, but you know, they were able to use the expressway for free going back as well. As a videographer, did he take photos of the situation?リズさんからの質問ですけども、はい、なんか撮られました？いろんなものを、
避難している間にでしょうか？
避難している間というか、うん、どんなものをそのビデオグラファーとしてなんか撮影された
さ撮影シューティングされたか
った。そう。
あ、ごめんなさい、してないです。
してない。Actually, unfortunately, he wasn't able to because he didn't even think about that situation. So, yeah, Liz. Yeah. So, Harry Cobier. Well, it's stuff like Taka's experience that I've never seen print.ハワイのハリーさんから、
はい、
全然メディアから聞けない情報を聞けてありがとうございますということで、コメントが聞いています。は
い、
Hey, is there any question you want to ask Borden?
I have a few.
Okay.
そう、タカさん、ご親戚やらお友達はみんな無事でしたか？
ですね、親戚、よろしいですか、喋って。
Hold on. So, let me...So how's the relative and family member? はい。
親戚もですね、津波に家を壊されてしまった親戚もいますし、住んでいたアパートがボロボロに壊れてしまった、親戚もいます。
So there are some, he has the relative that his house was damaged, his apartment was damaged. それは津波地震
ですね。いわきの海沿いでは津波ですね。うん、あと親戚の一部は仙台の方にアパートを借りていたんですけども、うん、仙台の方も、やはり、揺れがひどくて、
うん、
借りてたアパートはぐちゃぐちゃになったと言ってました。
So, he has relative in Sendai, Miyagi too, and then relative in Sendai, his apartment got damaged. So among his relative, he has the relative that damaged by earthquake and or just tsunami and stuff. Yeah. So.はい。Next, Jim?
ガソリンはまだ不足していますか?
Is there any gasoline shortage still? はい。
今は全く不足してなく、平常通りに戻ってますが、3月24日に戻、川崎からいわきに戻った段階では、まだ全然スタンドが機能してなくて、一部のスタンドで短時間で閉店してしまい、行列ができている状態でした。
うん、じゃあそれがいつまで続いたんでしょうかね。
それはですね、それから約1週間ぐらいは続いてましたね。うん、
So was he returned to Iwaki, Fukushima on March 24th, but it's about one week. The gas shortage was kind of lasted. So pretty much.じゃあそういうことは3月いっぱいってことですね。
そうですね。
So pretty much the rest of the March, Iwaki, Fukushima, he was experiencing the shortage of the gasoline. But right now, as it is right now, no gas shortage at all. はいはい。Jim?
Actually, I don't know quite how to ask the next one in Japanese.
Ask him in English, man.
I want to ask him, what's the biggest thing right now that he's hoping for?
今一番、なんていうのかな、願ってることって何でしょうかね?
望んでること、
うん、願ってることは2つあります。
He has two things that he's hoping the most right now、はい、
1つは、うん、原発の早期収束ですね。
Yeah, first thing is the, he wants this nuclear power plant incident getting settled, getting、resolved. はい。
はい。もう一つは、地震が早く収まってほしいですね。
And then second thing is that these aftershocks stops as well. はい。Then let me ask him the second mic from Mike and the people. S.Y. Shoring, Japan is an often quake country, but did he ever think about being hit by such tsunami? この津波まあもう僕らも地震に慣れてるわけですけれども、この津波のことどう思われました？
この津波ですか、やはり自然の力というのは、人間が計り知ることのできないものだということを感じました。
Well, he realized that, you know, this, the power of tsunami is the beyond human's capability, and that's what he realized. Yeah. じゃあSo let me ask him my question. You're welcome to ask him any question. So on the social timeline, but he has his website called iBreeze Iwate. He has the website called iBreezeIwaki.net. He tried to report what's going on in Iwaki, Fukushima, and with the YouTube video report. So I'm hoping he can come back continuously for this emergency broadcast to report what's going on in Fukushima too. If you have anything that you want him to cover, he's open to any suggestion as well. So please leave us the comment of what you want to know, what you want to see in Fukushima, Japan.As well, but maybe I'm going to ask him a question. So what do you think about my question is, what does he think about the Japanese government handling and then local government handling over the issue so far? じゃあ僕の方から質問させてもらおうと思うんですけれども、日本政府とこういう地域の、まあ、地方自治体のこの原発に対する対応ってざっくばらんにどう思われます？
ですね、地方、要は地方の例えばいわき市、福島県、それぞれ市長とか県、要は、それぞれこう、まあ、リーダーがいますよね。でそのリーダーたちは結局国の権限の下に置かれてますので、その地域の状態、例えば、すぐ避難させたいとかいう思いがあっても、国の指示がなければどうすることもできないという、本当にこうなんて言うんでしょうか、
その官僚主義というなん、そういう、縦割りというか、
その
縦割れの限界を感じられたって感じ、
その
地方自治体が縦割りの限界を感じられたという感じでしょうかね。
そういうことです。要は地方の、要は何ですか、党首というか、要は市長とか 県知事に 権限が全くないですね。
So, I asked him the question, what do you think about how Japanese government and local government handle this situation? And then he just answered that first of all, the local government, for example, city hall or prefecture office, he feels that, the Japanese the government system are the full of the bureaucracy. So he feels that the city and then prefecture, like a state, didn't have enough power to initiate this handling disaster. So he felt the limit of the how local government and city didn't have the authorization power to handle this disaster. So how about the Japanese government handling itself? じゃあ日本政府に対するこういう対応の仕方って今のところはどう思われます？
そうですね、国が思ってるの、国は国民がパニックを起こすことによって、想像しうるリスクを回避したいのかなという、
だつまり情報を隠してるっていうことですよね。
そういうことですね。
はい。
はい。
So how he consider Japanese government handling, he think that he thinks that the Japanese government is controlling the release of the information that the people don't get panic. So he feels that Japanese government is kind of controlling to release the information so that people don't get panicked. Then I ask him, so that's pretty much you did. So is that mean, do you think that the Japanese government is hiding some information? Then he said yes. So, 何を望んでられますこの政府とか地方自治体に今。So what do you want? What are you hoping for Japanese government and then prefecture office to think about this situation right now? はい、今、
はい、
その、はい、その、
はい、
何を国とか県とか市に望まれます、
第一に、国民の生命を守ってほしいですね。
The first of all, he wants Japanese government to protect the people's lives. はい。
はい、例えばその社会経済の混乱、まあ混乱、要は破綻とか、そういうことがあるのを恐れて、例えば原発周辺地域の人は犠牲になってくれ的なことはやめてほしい。
Okay. So, he think that, Japanese government, he doesn't, he doesn't like want to Japanese government to, let people in Fukushima to sacrifice. He want the people of Fukushima, he want Japanese government also try to save the people of the Fukushima too. So, okay. So, yeah. Yes. はい。他にはもうそんな感じで。
あ、そうですね。要は、いや、国民の生命を第一優先に考えてほしいですね。
そうです。はい、わかりました。はい。Let me ask him one more question then. So what did you think about this? Did you think that this evacuation order is still valid, and then so first of all, let me ask you. So where you are right now, are like some evacuation order still, or what's the current situation of where you are right now? じゃあ、今の、福島の、そのお住まいのところは、避難指示とかは全く出てないんですよね。
出てないです。はい。
So, where he lives right now, no evacuation order or evacuation prepare order in place. だ、避難準備でもないですよね。
そうです。僕が住んでいるエリアは、うん離れているのでないんですが、うん、いわき市の、うん北側の一部が、うん、久野浜、
うん、
が、かかったために、
うん、
いわき市すべてが、うん、要は危険なところ要は、うん、放射能に汚染された地域として認識されてます、
うん、So I just ask him that whatIs Iwaki is the part of the evacuation order? He said yes, but only one part, one district of the Iwaki, the north part of the Iwaki, is the part of the evacuation like suggestion area. So even many Japanese people think that Iwaki itself, entire Iwaki.Area are like evacuation order place, but that's not completely true. Let me add to this: the city of Iwaki is one of the largest city of Fukushima Prefecture. It's really large. So it's どんだけありましたっけ？いわき市の面積って。
いわき市の面積ですか？
うん。
ですね。即答できないですね。
まあ、でっかいですよね。
とにかくでかいですね。
そう、City of Iwaki is so huge. So, 何キロぐらいありましたっけ？端から端まで。
端から端までですか？
うん。
Iwaki City is 1,231.34
square kilometers. 1,000, okay, thank you, Jim. So 1,200 平方キロメートルですね。ありがとうございます、ジム。
ありがとうございます。
And then Iwaki, from one side to the other side of Iwaki City, it's like 30 miles, 50 kilometers long. So it's really, Iwaki City itself has a 50 kilometer span. So one part of the Iwaki may be dangerous, but the many part of the city of Iwaki is not dangerous by the radiation or have a threat of the... radiation. So that's what he wants to make sure that, yeah. So, Nethead, okay, I'm gonna ask you stream again. What was the first thing to flash through his mind when quake hits? ひとり、読者の方からのあれなんですけれども、
はい、
地震が起こった時に何を思い浮かんだというか、どういうことを考えられてましたか？まあ、リピートされてもいいですよ。途中から見てる視聴者の方もいると
思う、はい。どんな思いをされたか。
うん、
いよいよ来たかみたいな。
So, for our Sean, what was the first thing to flash through his mind when quake hits? And what he came up in his mind was,The time has come.
The time has come.
だいよいよ来たかっていうことは、
はい、
So let me ask him. So time. So he think the time has come. So that mean he was he expecting that earthquake like this gonna hit? だ、つまりこんな地震が来るんだろうかなというのはもう思われてたんですね。
そうですね。なんとなく僕が生きてる間に来ちゃったかなとは思いました、ね。
So he was, he just, you know, he think that, oh, me, oh, he think that、one day this kind of big quake would hit his、place, but、he wasn't sure that this quake will hit while he live.、But、this quake hit. So he kind of, you know, he was kind, you know, he kind of knew that this kind of quake was going to hit his hometown. But,、you know,、he also think that it's not necessary while he is alive. Yeah.
I thought same thing when it hit.
Yeah.
I thought, oh man, this has got to be the next Kanto earthquake, but it wasn't the Kanto earthquake.
Okay. あの、タカさん、ジムさんは埼玉県の加須市から来ていらっしゃるんですけども。
はい。はい。まあ、あの、東北道ですね。
うん。Yes.
あの、先ほど勝さん、あの、東北道で紹介してくれましたけども、
はいはい。
常磐道で避難しました。
あ、常磐 expressway. I'm sorry.
はい。
So he used the 常磐 expressway. I didn't mention about expressway, but、which expressway he took. But、Taka-san has used the 常磐 expressway to evacuate.Sorry. Maybe I mentioned as Tohoku Expressway, but、he didn't use Tohoku Expressway, but he used the 常磐 Expressway.
He probably used both.
両方と使ったんですか？え、常磐だけ？
私は行きも帰りも常磐道です。
あ、常磐 only 常磐 Expressway、は
い。ただ、うん、東北道も過去に何度も利用してますので。
うん、
え、両方とも知っております。
あ、で、まあ、もう今回は常磐だけ。
今回は常磐道オンリーですね。
はい、わかりました。常磐オンリーボーデン。
Oh
yeah. All right. So I guess that's pretty much it. So is if there's no other question, I'm going to turn it to the quick weekly update.
Because, I have one more question.
Yeah, go ahead.
とタカさんは40キロしか離れていないので、地震や原発の恐怖を経験しましたから、いわきから引っ越したいと思ったことがありますか？
Okay, let me ask. So Taka-san lives in 40 kilometers away from the nuclear power plant. So has he ever thought about moving out completely? はい。
原発の状態が本当に脅威ならば引っ越ししたか、したいです。
Mm. So if the threat of the、Fukushima nuclear power plant is really true, then he would consider moving out. その恐怖っていうのはどういう恐怖なんですか？ So what is that threat for you?What is the threat enough, like、enough threat to make you consider moving now? What kind of a degree of the threat he's talking about? どういう恐怖、どういう意味での具合での恐怖なんでしょうかね。
被爆ですね。
被爆、ああ、そう、radiation、the harmful、じゃもう人体に影響のある放射能っていうことですか。
そうですね。そうです。
でも放射能っていうにも放射能っていうにも、例えばある意味全体に影響のない放射能っていうのもあるじゃないですか。
それがわからないですね。
So he's not, but the problem is that you know, he told me that、he want to consider moving out to Iwaki Fukushima if the radiation is became like harmfulto the human body, but、you know, we talked that, but、the problem is that he doesn't know what is harmful amount of the radiation, so he's not sure about it. In the reflecting of what he and his family did, would he do anything differently? What do you mean, Liz? In talking about like action, what's the?
She means like if he thought back on the way he acted after the earthquake, what did
okay,
he do differently?
Got it, Liz. Thank you. Sorry, thank you, GM. Okay, このね、タカさん、
はい、
もし今思うに今までしてきたタカさんの行動で、はい、なんかしとけばよかったかなとかそういうのを悔やまれることというかそういうのなんかしとそれなんかあります？それともなかったらいいんですけど。
原発の周辺地域に住んでいた立場を考えると、
うん、
もえ
はい、もう一回ちょっと途切れたんですけどもう一回
原発周辺地域に生活して住んでいたものとして、
うん、
もっと原発要はその放射能であるとか、
うん、
その原発がトラブル起きたらどうなるのかとか、
うん、
そういったことに対する予備知識とか、
うん、
そういう理解度をもっと持っていなければいけなかったなと思います。
So he think that he because he lived nearby the nuclear power plant, so he now think that he should have known more about the nuclear power plant and then the knowledge of the radiation itself. So he think that he should have known better. So.はい、まあ、そうだからつまりでもいわき市になんていうのかな住んで仲よかったとは思わなかったんですね。
いわきに住んでなければよかった、
うん、というかそういうのは思わなかった。
とはそんなことはないです、全くないです。
So I just ask him a question. So how aboutDid you ever think that he shouldn't have lived in Iwaki, Fukushima at all? And then no, he said no, he never thought that he didn't want to like stay. Like he never regret living in Fukushima, living in Iwaki. はい、ありがとうございます。
ちなみに福島生まれですか？
私はいわき生まれのいわき育ちです。
So, Jim Borden asked him if he's born in Iwaki, Fukushima. Yes, he is born and raised in Iwaki, Fukushima. Yes. All right. Looks like a social timeline does not have any more question. And then I have a 3-hour recording limit of this Ustream. So I'm thinking about moving to the weekly update of this week. And then we can start wrapping up for a day, I think, unless you have...the question. But anything else, Jim?
Nope. That's good for me.
Okay, cool. So Taka-san is going to come back continuously throughout the time. You know, he's from the ibreezeiwaki.net.i-breeze-iwaki.net. He report continuously of what's happening in Iwaki, Japan. So I'm hoping him to come back continuously throughout the course of the week and stuff too. So please don't miss it. So I guess I'm going to go to the weekly update of the Japan last one week. So I guess that's for that's for the section of the Jim Borden talking about his life volunteer experience in Miyagi, and then Taka-san sharing the his experience of Iwaki, Fukushima. Thank you very much, Jim and Taka-san. じゃあ、Taka-san、どうもありがとうございました。こんな感じで。
ありがとうございました。お疲れ様でした。
お疲れ様です。
これからもよろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。じゃあ、Taka-san、普通の今週何が起こったかの、アップデートをしますんで、
はい、
ありがとうございましたっていう感じで。
こちらこそどうもありがとうございました。
はい、じゃあまた、あと打ち合わせしましょうっていう感じで。
はい、わかりました。
じゃあもう切っていただいて構わないので、
はい、
ありがとうございました。
それでは失礼いたします。
はい、ありがとうございました。All right, Jim, if you have to go, you can leave too. But you could stick around to make me some comp, help me some comp too. But
you got 20 minutes.
20 minutes, yes, I know. All right, so I'm going to try to summarize what happened between May 3rd, 2011 to May 10th of the 2011. Tomorrow is May 11th, which is, means the 2 month anniversary of the earthquake. What happened the last week to between May 3rd and May 10th? We talked about it briefly. Golden Week was in place, so so Golden Week is many tourism industries like money making season, but because of this earthquake they thought that they are going to lose money. But many actually people end up going to do something, but they didn't do like long term trip. They just went to like Tokyo. If people live in the Kanto area, they just went to Tokyo Disneyland or just nearby leisure, short distance leisure. So that's what they did during the Golden Week. So many aquarium, zoo, this, you know, theme park nearby the city were full of people. But many distant sightseeing, there are not so many long distance traveler happening Golden Week. But they had more customer than they thought. They have many last minute traveler coming back. So they lost money, but they didn't lose as much as that they thought. That's the update of the Golden Week. And then we had May 8th, the second week of the Sunday, which was the Mother's Day. So, you know, many people bought the carnation flower in the Tohoku area. And, you know, including the people who lost their mothers and stuff. And then, the main... Today's so many festival took place in Golden Week, so try to cheer up the you know, victim of tsunami and earthquake, and then Liz, is there any way to translate his site into English? That's what I'm going to do throughout the disaster update, Liz. That's going to happen next week. And then... for example, May 3rd, the group of Japanese people collect a donation to place the advertisement in Taiwan's newspaper, because many Japanese people were really appreciated by the people's Taiwan's donation. So people's Taiwan donated about 16 billion yen to Japan. So many Japanese people wanted to show the appreciation. So people got the donation, then they placed the advertisement in Taiwan's newspaper on the May 3rd. And then according to Japanese government, Japanese government, now Tohoku Expressway is kind of, they charge the money, as Borden said, in Japan Expressway they charge the money, but the Japanese government is considering to make the expressway free to kickstart more reconstruction, rebuilding effort. That's Japanese government start thinking about it. And Japanese government is consolidating all kinds of various team into three main teams for this reconstruction disaster effort, because Japanese government has been criticized of becoming too bureaucratic, too complicated in their team. And then like many university and elementary school and schools in Tohoku area finally start the new semester. So usually new semester school calendar, fiscal calendar mainly start in April, and because of this damage, many university in North area had to postpone. So many elementary school, university finally get back to the business like throughout the last week and this week. And then Emperor, Empress continue to visit the disaster area to cheer them up. And then the underwater search robot of Tokyo University was able to find a couple bodies in underwater of the east coast of Japan. There are still many people are missing. And then by the way, sumo tournament began, but it's free to watch. And then actually the sumo tournament is available to watch on the internet right now. I'm gonna cut it short, but you can actually watch the small tournament live on Nico Nico Live.
And it's live right now?
Not right now. But this week and next week, you can go to Nico Nico Live website from 2-3 p.m. Japan Standard Time to 6 p.m. Japan Standard Time or something. And then, now they need to take care of the debris. So there are some Miyagi Prefecture thinking about to construct waste disposal station right in the center of the national park, because national park supposed to be protected. Not the environment, you know, they are supposed to save the environment, but because massive amount of the debris that they need to process, the only place that they were able to find is right in the center of the national park of Matsushima. But they, you know, because they couldn't find any other link.
Would it be temporary or permanent?
I don't know. I just lost the link. my god, I just lost the link. Sorry, Borden.
Don't worry about it.
The next It's almost a 2 month anniversary. Many victims of tsunami and then the earthquake start running out of the money. Yomiuri reported that they really want the relief money coming. So many, as you know, Red Cross, Community Chest, your donation will be distributed to the victim of the tsunami and earthquake and Fukushima nuclear power plant. But because so massive amount of the paperwork and massive amount of the area, many people wasn't being able to get those relief aid money yet. So Yomiuri reported that it's almost been 2 months. And then, they really worry. Oh, okay, forum posted. So thank you. TBS, oh, I forgot to mention, TBS posted installed the live cam of the Fukushima nuclear power plant. So you will be able to watch the live of Fukushima nuclear power plant from TBS, Tokyo Broadcasting System, their news webcam. So, and according to self-defense on May 8th, 9th, and then self-defense personnel, they are going to start reducing the number from 100,000 member to 60,000 members. So as their knees is started to shift away, as the task shifted away to the construction, so their effort is becoming too more less. So less self-defense people now, more. And then let's go to the nuclear power plant. Quick nuclear power plant update. They finally, there are people inside of the first nuclear reactor's building. They clean up. They install the air filter. They were able to reduce the amount of the radiation. And then now people actually went into the first reactor's building and then start working there so that they can enhance the cooling process of the first nuclear reactor. However, they continue to find the radiation. For example, on the May 3rd, they found about 14,000 becquerel of the cesium-137 from the sea bottom of the 15 kilometers away from the Fukushima nuclear power plant. So they start finding the radiation accumulated at the sea bottom of the 15 kilometers away from the Fukushima nuclear power plant. And then today, the big news was about strontium? What? How do I pronounce it, Jim? Oh, the radiation started from the S and has a similar kind of behavior. Oh,
sorry, my mic was off.
Oh, it's okay. What was it?
Strontium.
Strontium. They found the strontium from the ocean today.
I said it like 5 times while my mic was muted.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry. sorry. Thank you. So, so that's the one of the news today too. And then what else? Second big news of the day is that Naoto Kan held the press conferences that 4 or 5 days ago, and he asked Chubu Electric Power, actually my area, to shut down. Not really my area, but my service area that I'm using. My studio is using Chubu Electric Power's power, and they have a nuclear power plant in Shizuoka Prefecture, which is about 100 kilometers away from where I live. But because the Hamaoka nuclear power plant does not have enough safety measurement. So Naoto Kan, Prime Minister, asked Chubu Electric Power to shut down the nuclear power plant. And then Chubu Electric Power agreed to shut down yesterday, and they are going to start shutting down process in a couple days. And this is the temporary shutdown. They are go until they build the high enough levees and more safety measurement against the tsunami and earthquake. And then concern is that because Chubu Electric Power was also providing power to the TEPCO, but because of this, they won't be able to supply the power to the TEPCO. So then Chubu Electric Power also supplying the power to Shikoku Electric Power and stuff, so helping, you know, because of this earthquake, every power company in Japan was kind of helping each other to minimize the loss by the loss of the TEPCO nuclear power plant and stuff. But the because Hamaoka nuclear power plant is going to shut down, so we now have to like pretty much power distribution system of the Japan is getting little bit of the conflict, and then we don't know how much this going to affect any industrial work and manufacturing job and that kind of stuff. So that's what we are talking about right now in Japan. But you know, people kind of say good thing about Prime Minister's decision to shut down, asked to shut down Hamaoka nuclear power plant, but yet many people actually criticize Naoto Kan that why, you know, this earthquake. The reason why Naoto Kan decided to shut down this earthquake, I mean, Hamaoka nuclear power plant, is because in around Hamaoka nuclear power plant, experts say they have 87% chance to experience M magnitude A class earthquake in 30 years. So experts says from now to 30 years, we have 87% chance to have magnitude A class earthquake. If that happens, maybe this Hamaoka nuclear power plant won't be able to withstand by tsunami because they don't have high enough levee. So that is the reason Prime Minister Naoto Kan and their team saw that Hamaoka nuclear power plant is the most risked nuclear power plant. So that's the reason why he requested to shut down. Then Chubu Electric Power
complied,
yeah. So then, you know, but you know, so like how are we gonna manage the manufacture planning, saving power, and then blah blah blah. So that's will be, I mean, right now they just decided to shut down, and then, you know, still it's going to be 1 month, 2 months until the summer really hits, so the usage of the power is more, you know, getting more concerned. So we kind of still have 1 month, 2 months to figure out what to do really. But do we need to buy more fossil fuel to run the thermal plant? You know, are we even be able to buy enough oil to run the thermal plant? That kind of stuff that we need to talk about. So that's
you see the news about 66 companies have gone bankrupt because of the earthquake.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. That's many company went bankrupt. Okay, three minutes left for the 3 hour gap of the recording. So I'm just gonna quickly wrap up, but I'm gonna continue the afterwards. So thank you very much for watching the recorded version archive for weekly emergency update of the Fukushima nuclear power plant. This is the 3/11 disaster update 36 from Yokoso News. Next show, it's going to be Japanese Curry Brainwashing Project live cast happening Sunday. For the USA, it's Saturday night in the USA, US time, but it's Sunday noon in Japan Standard Time, so don't miss it if you love curry rice. And then emergency live cast, it's coming back next Tuesday, May 17th. So I don't know what we're gonna talk about, but you know, we'll talk about throughout the week. But May 17th, we come back. So everyone, it has been the recorded archive of the weekly emergency update of the Fukushima nuclear power plant issue. We still have a Borden on the Skype, but Borden, just give me a thank you very much. We still continue the broadcast, but I'm just gonna wrap the archive recording. So thank you very much, Borden. Okay, so I'm gonna run the ending opening sequence, but I will come back for the live show. So
I'll be back.
I will be back for the live audience. But thank you very much for watching for the archive recorder, archive watcher. But thank you very much. And then.